When Adam, he commits sin, did Allah misguide Adam, or Adam, he did that by choice?
Allah knows. Allah knew that Adam is going
knowing.
To make
I'm
sin.
I'm asking you, did Allah misguide Adam, or Adam, he chose to commit sin?
Okay. So I'm answering that. So Allah knew that Adam is going to make sin.
This
The
is not
shaitan,
the question.
he deceived.
This is not the question. I want an answer. Did Allah misguide Adam, or Adam decide to commit sin? Why you need to play games in order to answer anything? Adam, he was was doing his sin, you know, willingly by himself. It's not Allah who misguide him, or it was Allah who misguide Adam and he commits sin. What do you think?
Yeah, okay. So, as I said before, that this life is a condemnation. So, Adam, he was Allah was also testing Adam. So, Adam, Allah knew that he was going to make
friend,
sin.
What's wrong with you? What's wrong with you? I'm not asking you if Allah is testing Adam or not. I'm asking you, when Adam commits sin, did he choose to commit sin, or Allah, he misguide him and force him to commit sin? The question is very simple. I'm not asking you if Allah is testing Adam or not testing Adam. The question is very simple. Did he choose to commit sin, or Allah,
Adam,
he forced him to commit sin and misguided him? Go ahead.
Adam chose to commit sin.
Adam, he chose to commit sin. So why you did not say that to me 5 minutes ago? Why need to repeat the question 1,000 times? What's wrong with Muslims?
Yes.
Now, hold on. Don't say yes. Hold on. So now you agree that Adam, he chose to commit sin, but you're a prophet, he said differently. You're a prophet, he says no. Allah, he deceived Adam. Let us go to the hadith and see how it worked. So, you're a prophet, he said, that Adam and Moses, they have a debate. Adam and Moses, they have a debate. So, Adam was accused by Moses. Shut up. Adam was accused by Moses that he, because of him, we are out of heaven. Then Adam, he said to Moses, well, you know what? Are you accusing me? Are you blaming me for something written in my destiny before Allah created me, 40 years before he created me? Read the hadith in front of you.
Okay, bro. I have not came here to talk about the hadith or any kind of Adam's sin.
We are connecting the information together to get the perfect image of the liar of the lies of Islam. So all of this proved to us that Allah is a liar. But when I asked you 2 minutes ago, did Adam choose to commit sin? You said, yes, you are lying to me, because the hadith in front of you is saying, no, it's written for Adam in a destiny that he will commit sin 40 years before his creation. Who is the one who made Adam sin? Read hadith. Why you are trying to escape it? Go ahead, read it.
You do not understand the Quran.
Abdul, here we have Adam and we have Moses. Moses argued with Adam, saying to him, you are our father who disappointed us and turned us out of paradise. So obviously Moses accused Adam, because of him we are out. And then Adam, he said to him, Moses, Allah favored you with his talk, which means he talked to you directly. And he wrote the Torah for you by his own hands. So Allah have hands to them in the right. Do you blame me for an action that Allah written in my fate 40 years before he created me? So when I asked you, do Adam choose to commit sin? You said, yes, he choose. You're a prophet saying the opposite. Adam was forced to commit sin because it was a fate and written in his book 40 years before he created him. Your mic.
Yeah, okay. So this is also in the Quran that said that I have made the world and I am going to set people on the earth. So that's Allah knew that Adam is going to make sin.
Abdul,
this was an example for
you. Where it says in you, it says he wrote his destiny. He's saying to him, you cannot blame me. Can we blame Adam for his sin, or we cannot? I'm asking you.
Yes, we can blame Adam because Adam
guys,
he used to.
Yes, we can blame Adam, but as you see, your prophet he agree with Adam that we cannot blame Adam because your prophet says so. Adam confuted.
Bro, you do not understand.
Don't tell me I don't understand. It's you who don't understand. It's you who blame not understanding. Does it say in front of you? Your prophet says so. Adam confuted Moses. Adam confuted Moses, and he repeat that 3 times as always because he is a Trinity person. So Adam confuted Moses. So your prophet agree that Adam was right and Moses was wrong. Adam was right about what? That we cannot blame him. So Muhammad agreed with Adam. You don't agree with Muhammad, don't you?
Okay, let me explain that. Allah even knew that today I am going to
stop saying in you. Do you see the word blame? You see the core of this conversation, the core of this conversation is I blame you and you cannot blame me. So Adam saying to him, do you blame me? So this is not about Allah knowing. This is about Allah writing your fate. This is not about Allah knowing. He wrote his fate. So it's a fate. And fate means it's something you cannot change. Correct?
Only Allah knew that what is going
this
to happen.
Is not the question.
You do not know that.
What's wrong with you? Does it say, do you blame me for an action Allah written for him in my fate? When he says written in my fate.
Okay, so you cannot blame Allah for that because...
Do you blame me for an action? Do you blame me? Not saying to Allah, do you blame me? Do you blame me? Do you blame me? And who is talking about blaming Allah now? Do you blame me? So Adam saying, you cannot blame me. Correct?
He's saying that Adam. Adam is saying that.
Huh?
Who is saying that?
After all of this, now you're asking me where it says that? This is the Da'if Hadith. It's in the screen. Read it.
You said the Hadith is Da'if. This is not a...
So what if it's Da'if? It's not accepted now?
Because if it's the Da'if Hadith, then it's not acceptable.
Okay, so if it's Sahih, it's accepted?
Then you have to accept that.
Now, hold on. If it is sahih, you have to accept it 100%, you said, correct?
If it's sahih, yes, you have to.
So now a Christian prince is in trouble because the hadith is da'if. But we need to find you a sahih hadith. Guess what? I was practicing Islam with you 5 minutes ago. I was lying to you. It is not da'if, it is sahih. Just to show everybody how Muslims are a bunch of liars. They play games as much as they can. So now he found a rope to hold. Oh, it's da'if. We don't accept it. I accept it only if it's sahih. It is sahih. And this is sahih al-Bukhari. So now do you admit that we cannot blame Adam for the sin? He hang up the coward. He hang up the coward. He hang up the coward. My friend, you are an ignorant. You do not know what the Quran is teaching and you do not know what your religion is teaching.
Pembahasan singkat. Dari sini kita dapat mengetahui bahwa salah satu jurus yang digunakan oleh Muslim dalam berdebat adalah, mereka Muslim berusaha sebisa mungkin untuk menolak dalilnya sendiri ketika mereka kejepit. Tetapi ketika dalil itu diperlukan untuk memperkuat argumen mereka, Muslim akan dengan lantang mengatakan, "Hey, inilah dalilnya." Tetapi jika dalil tersebut bertentangan dengan argumennya, maka Muslim akan berbohong dengan segala cara. Seperti yang telah kita lihat bersama pada hadis tersebut, dijelaskan bahwa Allah SWT telah menetapkan kepada Adam, bahwa Adam diciptakan salah satu tujuannya adalah untuk melakukan dosa, yang mana ketetapan ini telah ditetapkan oleh Allah SWT 40 tahun sebelum Adam diciptakan. Walaupun Christian Prince telah menunjukkan hadis tersebut, namun Muslim itu tetap mati-matian membantah hadis tersebut, dengan membuat narasinya sendiri. Tetapi, ketika Christian Prince mengatakan bahwa hadis tersebut merupakan hadis do'if, si Muslim langsung berubah pikiran dengan mengatakan bahwa hadis tersebut bisa ditolak. Namun, ketika Christian Prince menunjukkan fakta yang sebenarnya, bahwa hadis tersebut bukanlah hadis do'if melainkan hadis sahih, si Muslim langsung menutup teleponnya, alias kabur. Sekarang, jika berbicara mengenai dosa menurut pandangan Islam, di dalam hadis juga dijelaskan bahwa Allah SWT lebih senang jika manusia melakukan dosa. Di dalam hadis Sahih Muslim, dijelaskan, Abu Ayyub Ansari melaporkan bahwa Rasulullah berkata, jika Anda tidak melakukan dosa, Allah akan menyapu Anda keluar dari keberadaan dan akan menggantikan Anda dengan orang lain yang telah melakukan dosa, dan kemudian meminta pengampunan dari Allah, dan Dia akan memberikan mereka pengampunan. Jika di dalam agama Kristen, Tuhan melarang umatnya agar tidak melakukan dosa. Tetapi sebaliknya, di dalam Islam Allah SWT justru menghimbau umatnya agar melakukan dosa.